Warming up has become grossly overcomplicated in recent years, and it is one of the most simple things in all of exercise. I'm not gonna bury the lead here and just tell you the most important thing when it comes to warming up is just that, warming up, literally. Core body temperature elevation is highly associated with all of the performance benefits you are looking for. Some of the early researchers on this topic, A and B, I'm gonna call them because I can't pronounce that B name, sorry, said that organisms facilitate work more effectively at higher temperatures. And since then, we've gotten dozens of studies on this topic. Multiple studies found a roughly 2 to 5% increase in power output for every 1 degree Celsius the temperature of the muscle increased. The muscle fiber performance also improves when warmer. This includes both slow and fast fibers, but fast fibers seem to see more of a benefit. And fast fibers have twice the potential for growth as their slow counterparts, by the way. Warm muscles can more easily and quickly receive and send signals from the brain, allowing for better reaction times. Other studies on circadian rhythm and performance also found a correlation between core body temperature and exercise performance. Warmer was better for performance. Now say what you will about some of the more bro school people, the old school bodybuilders and so on, but they've got some stuff figured out. Actually, I think they've got plenty of things figured out, warming up being one of them. For the most part, the bodybuilder types will walk into the gym with a hoodie, hop on the treadmill for a bit, and then start doing warm-up sets with whatever their first exercise was going to be. And this is all you really need for a warm-up. Wear something warm, walk on the treadmill for a few minutes, and then start pyramiding up in weight on whatever your first exercise or exercises are. Once you've worked up sweat, you're ready to go. Since we're talking about warming up, I'll only go over the effects foam rolling has when done pre-workout. The short answer is it does very little, if anything. Now, I like to think about things in the gym in terms of what will get me the most bang for my buck. So it's not totally about does foam rolling work, but more so about does it work better than other things that you could be doing. And the answer is, well, not really. When compared to dynamic stretching, which is every dynamic resistance exercise, squats, push-ups, chin-ups, all of them count as dynamic stretches as well. Foam rolling doesn't quite measure up. This is also why I said earlier, use the exercise or exercises you're doing first in your program to warm up. One, it will be a dynamic stretch, and dynamic stretching outperforms everything, except warming up for warm-up purposes. And two, you'll prime the nervous system for the specific exercise you're doing, which follows the law of specificity. Foam rolling does come with an acute increase in flexibility, which is good, of course. However, the effect is very acute. One study compared static stretching and foam rolling and found they were equally effective for increasing range of motion. However, the flexibility increase had gone away after about 10 minutes. Now, this could mean you could use foam rolling as a way to get yourself moving if you're feeling particularly stiff, but in general, research has found the effect of foam rolling is no better or worse when compared to static stretching for increasing range of motion. These same studies also found that there is no compounding effect when combining stretching and foam rolling, meaning you won't get more flexible if you do both. And speaking of static stretching, how does static stretching perform for warm-up purposes? Terribly. Straight like that. Static stretching has no carryover to functional tasks and generally only makes you better at stretching. For example, doing a hamstring stretch isn't going to improve stiff leg deadlift range of motion. Your nervous system is smarter than that, or dumber, depending on how you look at it. But stretching doesn't keep you from getting injured either, and stretching negatively impacts weightlifting performance. So I would stay far away from it pre-workout. If stretching is something you enjoy, you can do it after. Or if you want to get better at stretching, like you want to do the splits, for example, then of course you'll need to stretch. But the best way to increase range of motion on an exercise is to use that particular exercise. Now, if you want to learn more about the science of stretching, I've got another video right here for you. The link to check out the Muscle Wiki app is just below it. We've got 2,000 exercises, 100 plus workouts, and our new workout generator that'll create you a custom workout based on your unique goals and body. I'm Coach Ty with Muscle Wiki. I will see you with the next one. Deuces.